Hello, I am Dr. Dhananjay Chavan, dermatologist and hair transplant surgeon at HairMD and Clear Skin Pune. We will discuss about minoxidil today, that is formulation, 2% minoxidil, 5% minoxidil, and there are 10% minoxidil solutions, 3% minoxidil solutions, 7% minoxidil, lot of percentage medicine has come into the market. We'll discuss something about that. First of all, US FDA has approved minoxidil for postponing or preventing the baldness or thinning of hair, especially in pattern baldness, that is either male pattern baldness and female pattern baldness. Initially, 2% minoxidil was approved for baldness in both, in female also and male also. But 5% immediately it was again approved, especially or mainly for male pattern baldness, because it was proved that instead of 2%, 5% minoxidil gives better results in male. But in case of female, if you use 5% or if you use 2%, it doesn't make any difference as per results. So in female, they have restricted use of minoxidil to 2% only, because 5% minoxidil, especially in female, may lead to unwanted hair growth or other adverse effect. So 2% minoxidil, yes, if a person is more than 18 years of old, when he is having pattern baldness, or whenever family hair loss history is there, or you are diagnosed as baldness person, male pattern baldness or female pattern baldness, then 2% minoxidil is useful. It has to be used in twice a day form, 1 ml in the morning, 1 ml at night, and minimum 2 to 4 months it takes to show its results. If your hair loss or thinning of hair doesn't show any improvement in 4 months time, then minoxidil is useless for your hair loss or your baldness. It is not working in your case. Then you should stop. Initially, after application of minoxidil, in couple of weeks or in months time, you may see that your hair loss is increased. Yes, this thing happens because with minoxidil, the telogen hairs, they are shed off and new anagen phase starts. This is positive sign that minoxidil is working in your case. So don't get frightened just due to excess hair loss. It might be good sign. But if after applying also minoxidil 2%, after 1 month or 2 months, still you continue your hair loss, excessive hair loss, then minoxidil is not working in your case. You should consult your dermatologist. Now, what about 2% minoxidil when it is used, especially in female? It should be avoided in pregnant female, lactating female. They should not use. It is avoided in children's, and it is avoided in any other hormonal hair loss other than pattern baldness. Especially drug-induced hair loss, telogen effluvium, or cicatricial alopecia, or hair loss due to any hair-related treatment and all this thing. Especially in these cases, it may not be useful. Even not each and every female or each and every male will respond very well to the 2% minoxidil or 5% minoxidil. Minoxidil's response is unpredictable. In few patients, it gives very good result, but in few patients, it may not give good results at all. then after 4 months you should stop. About 5% minoxidil, especially it is recommended for male pattern baldness, and male pattern baldness or androgenetic alopecia in males. Again, more than 18 years of age, female, they should avoid 5% because there is no advantage of it. Or in males more than 18 years of age, not in 16 years or 15 years, or in children, it should not be used. In male also, it has to be applied twice a day, morning 1 ml and night 1 ml. And especially if you cut your hair small, then chances of minoxidil to get applied over the scalp instead of the hair shaft will be more. So 1 ml minoxidil will be sufficient to cover whole scalp area which is going to become bald or which is thinning. So having short hair will increase efficacy of minoxidil in majority of persons. Again, here also, not all men will respond similarly to the minoxidil. Its response is unpredictable. So some patients may respond well, some may not respond well. The time duration, if it doesn't respond in 4 months' time, better to stop instead of continuously using it. Initial shedding of hair and all this thing is same, like 2% what we use. Third important thing about 2% and 5% minoxidil is how to use, when to use. Already I have explained in another video how to use, whether after bath and all this thing. When to stop minoxidil? Yes, especially after 4 months, if you don't get a response, better stop it and consult your dermatologist again, revive what may be the cause for your hair loss. If you don't have got any family history of thinning or loss and all this thing, then chances that your hair loss might be due to some other causes. Remember one thing, 10% minoxidil, 3% minoxidil, or there are so many other combination of minoxidil, not much study and not much FDA approval is there. Evidence based, in some patient, especially the patients in which hair loss is for a longer time, grade 5, grade 6 hair loss is there, then in some patient, 10% minoxidil is working in better form, but it is not proved beyond doubt. In some patient, it will not respond. Suppose a person respond to male, especially female, nothing more than 2%. But in male, suppose somebody uses 10% minoxidil, it is very difficult to come down to 5%. In majority of patient, if they respond well to 10% minoxidil, and after some time, after 6 months, 1 year, if that person reapply 10% instead of 10%, 5% minoxidil, then hair loss may increase. So before starting 10% minoxidil, you have to think 10 times before starting 10% minoxidil, because it is not US FDA approved. It is evidence based, and in few patient it may give results. Twice a day application for minimum 4 months is important. When you will stop use of minoxidil, what will happen? Whatever thinning of your hair has occurred, or premature anagen phase usually occurs in those baldness patients, then in those patients, again, effect of minoxidil vanishes if you stop in couple of months or 2-3 months time, and then again shedding starts, thinning starts, and then the patient may feel that after stopping minoxidil, my hair loss has increased or my baldness has increased more than what it was. Yes, it is going to, because temporarily minoxidil postpones your baldness. Temporarily minoxidil, whenever applied, then it reduces the thinning, it makes hair thin, it increases anagen phase. Whenever you will stop, again nature will take, hormones will have their own action and baldness will start. So before starting minoxidil, you should think, you should have consultation of dermatologist so that he can help you how to take out the minoxidil. I think other combination, minoxidil with aminoxidil, minoxidil with finasteride, minoxidil with capexil and all these things, studies are going on. When minoxidil itself, its action is when not predicted, then all these combinations live apart. Its action also not predicted in some patient. It may give action, some patient may not give action. In receding hairline also, majority of patients, they do not get response. But few patients gets response with either 2% or 5% minoxidil. So response to minoxidil is unpredictable. If you get, you are lucky. If you don't get, don't feel shy. There are other ways where we can treat it. If you got still any more difficulty or some any questions regarding minoxidil, yes, write down or email us. We will try to answer you, or visit our website www.hairmdindia.com, where we update information about hair loss and management of hair loss. There also you can ask questions. We will try to answer it as early as possible. Or you can subscribe to our YouTube channel also. We'll try to update you as early as possible. Thank you. Thank you very much.